बात दिस इज अजीक। लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव सीन समथिंग अबाउट स्प्रिंग एंड स्प्रिंग फेमवर्क इन द बैचेस स्प्रिंग एमबीसी या क्लास नोट्स। लास्ट वीडियो लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव दिस इज द सिलेबस अवर वी विल कंप्लीट ऑन इन दिस बैच। दिस इज अबाउट द स्प्रिंग फ्रेमवर्क। दिस इज द ऑल अबाउट द स्प्रिंग फ्रेमवर्क। ओके एंड दिस इज द स्प्रिंग एमबीसी। नाउ इन दिस सेशन आई विल टीच यू हाउ टू प्रिपेयर स्प्रिंग एमबीसी एप्लीकेशन यूजिंग एक्लिप्स आईडीई। If you those people don't know how to use Eclipse ID, just follow my instruction in this video. I will tell all this point. So before discussing anything about Spring related, so now I am going to prepare one Spring MVC example. Okay, just printing message. Wait some time, it's opening. Wait some time, it's taking time, you know. So now here, write it. Prepare one document, new document, new. Now, okay, now prepare first Spring MVC project by using Eclipse. Okay. Nowadays, jar file is not there internet. So I will share all jar files in my Telegram channel. Okay, so you will download. You can download from the my channel, Telegram channel. Sorry, Telegram channel. So you can download from there. Okay, and these links I will provide in the video description. Download. Okay. I will provide this jar zip file on Java programming. I think this is the channel name. My team will upload that. Okay. Why? Because right now some repository I did not there. It's not there in the. It's, I search a lot of. I do hard work on the how to download kind of thing for the showing purpose. But I did not recognize any websites there in the nowadays. So I think Spring people remove the repository to download jar files. I don't know what happened. It's the internal purpose. So I download previously last. Okay. So I will share 5.x version I have download. So I will share these jar files. Those jar files I will use that. Okay. So now Spring MVC launch. Yes. Okay. Spring MVC MVC. Now, how to prepare by using Eclipse ID, by using dynamic project. Here I will not use, I'll not use any tools. Okay, like Gradle and Maven. First two or three examples I will show only by using dynamic project. After two, three examples, I will use frequently Maven or Gradle tool, both. Okay, one by one. If you don't know how to install Tomcat and Eclipse ID and like configure Tomcat in your Eclipse ID, go my YouTube channel, search YouTube, search on YouTube, search on YouTube. सर्च ऑन यूट्यूब, सर्च आईट्रिक स्टडी पार्क, आईट्रिक स्टडी पार्क। सुना ए विल गेट 1 मिनट वीडियोस आर देयर आई थिंक। सुना यस यस दिस वीडियोस आर द टॉम कैट सर्वर इंस्टॉलेशन एंड कॉन्फ़िगरेशन विद इक्लिप्स आईडी। गो एंड वॉच। ओके हियर इन दिस वीडियो आई विल नॉट टेल यू हाउ टू कॉन्फ़िगर इक्लिप्स आईडी, हाउ टू कॉन्फ़िगर टॉम कैट विद इक्लिप्स आईडी। आई विल नॉट So now, simple simple steps are there. Okay, just follow. Okay, it's opening. It's taking time. It depends on your system. Wait. Now it's done. Now last video in this video I have teach you all this point how to configure. I have already configured Tomcat in my Eclipse. Okay, so now just click on, let's check it out. Go one time preferences, if you don't know just I'll check. Go preferences and search server. I already here is Tomcat server is not there. I want to configure one more time. Okay, I will change. So open add button. I have shared one document with you guys in my channel. Create next browse where your directory exists. Okay, the server is mandatory for you guys. Okay, lib select this. So in my case, program file Apache Tomcat, just select Tomcat 9. That's it. Directory will reflect it and click finish button. Just click and apply and close. Now your server is configured with your Eclipse ID. This is the simple step. There I will teach more. I will repeat one or two times same steps. That's why it's taking it. Takes too much time. So now it's preparing refreshing server adapter list. Okay, so wait. Here I will prepare simple one wish message to the user. Okay, interact with the one controller. I will create one controller. Okay, those controller generate one wish message and simple display to the user. Okay, just one simple message. Okay, dynamically generated message. Right. Okay, let's see here, add server. Add server next. Yes, and there is no project. So now your server is added in this area. Now we will get one server folder here. If you're preparing web application, the server folder should be open mode, not a close. If you close, then it will not, your project will not recognize any jar files related thing. So now how to create project? Simple. Click on file, new. Dynamic project, search dynamic project. If dynamic project is not there, just click on other, you will get it. Search it, dynamic web project. Just put a number first. This is our first project, Spring MVC MVC Visha. Okay, and using XML approach. XML. So click on next. This is our folder. Next, I want to generate web.xml deployment descriptor. Web.xml, in technical term, this file is called deployment descriptor. Here we provide all this type of information like configuration, security configuration. I will teach, I will taught, I will discuss this point also in this video, okay? But in the requirement and all these things, I will do. Just for the demonstration purpose, I will show this example, guys. Then you can, when I teach theory, when I will teach theory, then you can relate both the things. That's why I planned. First, I will discuss with you how to create projects. Okay. It's preparing. Okay, I will teach you which jar file is required. Now create this. We will get this type of things like inside the lib folder. You put it all jars file related spring related jar file. You put it. If you require any jar file in your project, just put inside the lib folder. That's it. Today is. Okay, this is the SRC. Here you can create packages and folders, all these things. How to put jar files? Just in my case, I have already downloaded. Some jar files. So now, how many jar files required to develop? I will share also detail. One screenshot I will share with you guys. Okay. Just copy the jar files from there, here, in batches, software, and anywhere spring related thing out there. No, server IDs. Not there. Let's check it out one time, guys. Installation downs. No, this is the database Eclipse SQL Developer JDK. No. Here is not my, okay, Spring MVC, this is our file. New folder, is there anything? No. This is the last session. MVC, this is the class mode, it's the project folder. Okay, where I put it there, guys? Now, guys, Eclipse ID SQL developer. Wait. On software, MVC. Let's check it out on that. Yeah, one by one, we will check. No. IDs. Yes. This is the Spring JARS is there. Okay. Come out this package. In Spring JARS, one zip file is there, 5.2.3 release. So now extract this jar, then you will get one folder. Extract here. That's it. Spring release, open source, Spring software is a open source. It's release documentation as well as source code also. You can see the source code also. That's why I love open source technology. They will not provide any hide and seek kind of thing with us, guys. Our technical guy, so they are not providing any type of hiding from the Spring framework. Spring framework is a very, very useful framework nowadays. And also Spring Boot. Now its boom is Spring Boot right now. After the completion, I'm planning to start Spring Boot also. don't worry, if you subscribe this channel and you join with this channel, you will get all type of technologies free of cost. I will not charge single paisa. Okay, don't worry. Just is extract and which jar file is required, I will tell. Just click on the Spring Framework Lips. If you want to read some documentation, go in the documentation. That's it. Release AOP. AOP is required. Yes, one more jar is required. What is the jar? Log. Logging jar. Okay. Not a logging. Logs jar, I think. So common logging. Yeah, common logging jar is required for us. That jar I will download from the internet. Don't worry. This jar, that jar is available on the internet. Aspect is required, beans is required, context required, and context source is there. Context indexer not required. Core is required. Spring core. Previously, context. And expansion is not required right now, just as a security purpose. GSEL, JDBC not required, and all these things are. Transaction is not required, test is also not required, and BIB is required, and one thing, BIB MBC is also required. These jar is required. Just copy these jars and put it on your folder, which is folder lift, just paste it. 9 minutes. Paste in the lift folder. Now, one more jar is required. What is the jar name is? Commons login jar is required. That jar also is not available in my system. So now I download from the internet. Just common jar, common login jar, the search, download latest version commons log, not responding. Sometimes my system do this type of hangama. Okay, food. Why? I don't know, guys. It's having 4 GB RAM. Download Apache Commons login. Just click on this site. Download latest version. Zip file. And download. Just download it. Click on this, download it. Okay, download. Download it completion. Download is completed. Okay. Let's see. Control X. Paste inside the our software folder is Spring Software. So okay, test it and extract it. We will get 2 or 3 files, I think. Okay, commons logins. This jar is required, not docs is not required. Control C and paste here. Now this jar as required. Give the screenshot for you guys. Don't worry. Okay. Now right here. Required jar file for developing Spring simple application. just paste these jars are required. That's it. So now come. Now our ready. So now first we prepare. What is that? First we prepare beb.xml file. This beb.xml file is existed. So now, so inside the beb.xml, you provide the configuration of the dispatcher servlet. So here is our responsibility is not to create dispatcher servlet, just provide the predefined class name. So Spring framework, Spring MVC framework, provide the dispatcher servlet as the predefined. So not required. Okay. Here, just improve the size of this. Preferences. I think it's not visible now, guys. Preferences, up journal, appearance, color and font, basic, and text font, edit. Calibri or Arial, whatever font you want, just select bold. I want to bold and 16 is good. Okay, apply and close. That's it. Font is visible. Now here, provide the tag. Don't mug up, but I will teach all these things. These type of tags I am providing here and I will discuss. I will give a theory also. Just for the knowledge. Just here, servlet. This is the simple, like in the servlet session, in advanced Java servlet session, how to configure the your dispatcher servlet, your servlet inside the web.xml file. Same thing is there. Servlet, inside the servlet, just provide servlet name, dispatcher, that's it. Provide the dispatcher here, servlet class, servlet hyphen class. Just click on this servlet class will come. What is the class name? Is org dot spring framework, org dot spring framework dot web dot I think so web dot servlet dot web dot servlet dot web dot servlet dot servlet dot dispatcher servlet. Now one important thing, provide the load and startup. This is the mandatory. Load and startup to its responsibility to configure and initialize the dispatcher servlet at the time of starting a server. Here provide the mapping servlet mapping is the intact. Just provide the logical name of the servlet name. What is the dispatcher servlet? Now something is the mandatory. I will tell you URL pattern. Just provide exact matching or URL matching. Just I am providing ds. Okay, star.ds. This is the exact matching URL pattern. Okay. As today, my system is so slow. I don't know why. Just close all the things. Those are not required. Just close it. Yes. Our web.xml file is ready. Now, next thing, we provide one bish file. Also, in the bish file or JSP file, you can provide inside that web.inf folder. After that, I will provide the directory structure also as a screenshot. So we'll get clarity, guys. Right click, create one JSP page. न्यू जेएसपी सिंपल कोटेड विस डॉट जेएसपी दैट्स इट. नाउ नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट फिनिश. जस्ट प्रोवाइड वन दिस मैसेज. ओके प्रिंट वन दिस मैसेज लाइक एच वन टैग. आई वॉन्ट टू प्रिंट इन द सेंटर सो पुट सेंटर टैग एंड एच वन टैग एंड एच वन टैग इन साइड द वेलकम टू Welcome to iTrick study part Mr. or Mrs. whatever. So lamenti shine and here provide one thing. What is that? Use GSP expression language. Okay, provide that, what is that? Provide one symbol, dollar, of course, message. That's it. But if you're using GSP tag, so just here, you provide one thing, not required these many things. Just provide page is EL ignored as a false. Default is true, I think so. So now I provide false, now error has gone. So now our base page is ready. Now, one, when you execute this program, one file will execute. What is the file? Its configuration is existed inside the web.xml file. What is that? index.jsp. So at the time of the loading server, it will execute it. So we are not providing the request to the user, in the URL. Like we are not, we cannot provide URL in the address bar, URL bar, okay? So now you can prepare simple one controller. What is that controller name? Package, provide one package. form.itsp.controller. That's it. Finish. Now package is created. Inside the package, create one class called bish controller. The bish controller is control or trap the request bish controller is the class. Now implement one controller class which is provided by Spring Framework controller class java.spring.web. Okay, this file. Just add it and finish. Controller class having one method called model and view. Model and view object is returning handler request. Why guys is taking too much time? Yes. Now your controller class is ready. So here you can provide the message. Okay, here you can provide the message and to the user. Which message you want, just now it's not required. What is that? Just focus which output you will get. Okay, just focus on that. How to prepare a string up Spring MVC application by using Eclipse IDE. This is the today's agenda. Okay. Here, all this thing is not required for you guys. I will discuss in depth all these things and more practical, more practical. This batch, Spring MVC batch, I will do. I will do more and more practice. Okay. For you guys also, I will use Git. I will use Git. That Git link I will also share in the future. Okay, because we develop big projects like Spring MVC. Okay, when using internalization, using Hindi, English, all these things, I will use how to convert English to Hindi, Hindi to data, kind of upload a file, all these things. That's why. So I'm unable to. I'm not that much interested to share this code on. What is that? In the MS Paint. Okay, Paint Brush. So I will share on, I will use Git. Okay, before I will use Git, I will teach you. So here we create one model and view object. Model and view object. Why? Because this method is returning model and view. So here configure model and view. MAV equals to new model and view. New model and view. That's it. Here you pass. You pass. Here you can pass the wish. Page name. Here you can pass. Here pass the variable. Here you can pass the variable. Which variable you pass inside that? Inside that where? This is the message generated the dynamically. MSG. That's it. Here you can provide the message. Welcome to iTrick Study Park. Welcome to iTrick Study Park. Not required here, I think. Nah? This message is not good. Here, not providing. Nah? So, provide one simple user. Hello user. Yeah, good. Hello user. Hello user. Welcome to IT case study. This is running good. So come here, controller class. Save it. Come controller class. Just provide. Hello user. Welcome to IT study. And return the mau object. Yeah, maybe object you can return. That's it. Your controller is ready. Now, one thing, one file is remaining. What's this? These are the component. Okay. These are the view component. This is the also one component. This is the also component I will discuss. I will give a list, one very good list. So here in the web.inf file, one create one file called dispatch a servlet file. So this is the XML file. Search here any file is there. Search XML. XML. Here XML file. Just created XML file. Okay, here you provide dispatcher hyphen servlet. This is the mandatory to provide logical name, first logical name, then hyphen servlet dot XML. If you violate this rule, your project will not execute. If you don't want to provide predefined name, then use init param. Init param, provide the init param. I will give a theory and also practical, guys. Don't worry. So just click on next. I want this just next finish. That's it. Now here required one XSD. How you will get XSD? If you install in your Eclipse IDE, like Spring Boot, then a Spring Boot framework provides very good. Spring Boot provides automatic getting XSDs. Okay, so here is not, I'm not installed. I have not installed like Spring Boot. So where I will get, so go inside that, go your project here, this libs, go and docs, reference docs, open the docs like MB web, open web. In the documentation, you can find out easily all these things there in the documentation. So search, control F, press control F, search. What is that? XSD. Yes. Now copy this XSD. Now, right now is this XSD is required. Okay. Copy this. Copy this. Copy this and just paste it here. That's it. Now close that bin. Now close it. Mean closes. That's it. Here provide the view resolver configuration, controller configuration, and handler mapping. All these things you should provide here. Okay. So now first provide our Veeam class, controller class Veeam. This is the tag. Also, I will tell you why use this tag. Why we use this tag? Provide the Veeam. Inside the Veeam, provide one ID. ID should be same as suppose Wish. Okay. Wish class name is com.itsp.controller. Okay. Controller dot wish controller. What is that? Wish controller. Wish controller. That's it. Provide this. Now, next thing is provide the handler mapping. Handler mapping. After that, I will tell you what do the handler mapping. Okay. So now this is the fixed property. ID, otherwise, this is a fixed property. Handler mapping. Class is, if you don't know how to provide the classes, just simple, click on any controller, go in the controller. Just, I will use, what is that? Bean handler mapping, bean handler mapping, bean URL, just bean. Bean, what is that? Bean name is there, and just bean name URL handle mapping. I will leave this. So simple. If you use this, then you will get this. Just you require this. Control X, remove this. This is the shortcut bay. Not required to remember all these things, guys. Just copy and paste all the things. Okay. Plus that's it. Your bean handler URL mapping is configured with your dispatcher servlet. Now provide the view resolver. Provide the view resolver to identify the where your file is, JSP file is existed. So now bean name or ID, whatever you want, you can provide view resolver. This is the property name, it's a fixed name class. Equals to, if you want to this class, just go controller. I will use, what is that class name? I will use internal view resolver, resource resolver. I will use this one as views. I will use, just copy, remove here, not required, save it, come inside this, control V. So right now it's not required to close here. Just why? Because view resolver having two properties. What is the properties? Prefix and suffix. Provide the prefix of the resolver and suffix of the resolver. So property property name equals to prefix. And provide the value of that. So provide first start with the web hyphen inf, web hyphen inf and slash, close with the slash and close this property. And second property is identify the name of the files. Prefix. Suffix means the first and prefix means last. Suffix. Suffix value equals to .jsp. Now your configuration is ready. Now your program is ready for the execution. Let's try. If it's not running, if it's not run successfully, then we will check. Okay, everything is the learning process. We will get any error and exception. Just right click on your project. Then anything is required, web.xml will provide. Okay. Everything will provide, na? Yes. Just click on this, next. Okay. Now here, provide the URL of that. What's the URL? wish.ds, I think so. Now it's not recognizing wish.ds in file. Page not found, servlet not found, no handler. Okay, no issue. Let's check it out. wish.dispatch and servlet, wish.ds, I think so, no? We provide here this.ds. Okay, not a issue. Everything in the learning app. Okay. Just now, this is there. Controller inside the controller. Okay, this is show. Okay, let's try one more time. You start a server, okay. Let's check it out. wish.ds. Now. We will get the output. User, hello user, welcome to iTrick Study Bar. That's it. This is the output. Okay, this is the structure. Now you will get output. Okay. Now I want to share. I'm sharing with this. This is structure, directory structure for you guys. Control C. So today's my system is little bit slow. Okay. So we will continue next session. Okay. So today we will wind up the session. I will share this code also, don't worry. Okay, indexing is not required, providing the index also I will tell you. Oh, next session I will teach all these things. What is this? What is this? Please don't miss this last next session. No, this all these things is not required. This one is required. That's it. So, right. What is that? Web.xml file. Why this? That's it. The bold. Okay. Now, web.xml file is good. Now next file is provide the next file. What happened? Okay, wish. No issue. I will provide you only wish.jsp. That's wish.jsp. Just bold. Now next is wish controller. Okay, this is the packages. Okay. Let's see. Let's see. What is the name of the wish controller? Not dot java. That's it. Hold it. This is the wish controller. Okay. Now next part is dispatches submit is reminding. We share dispatches hello. This is shared web.x for dispatches hello. Both okay. Now here. What is that? Dispatches hello. I find servlet. Please. One time practice this example. Okay, one time practice this example. We will meet next session. We will meet next session. So there I will teach all these things. What is this? What is this? Why are we using this? Why are we using all these things? I will teach. Okay. Just run this example. Your target is run this example. That's it. Your target is just run this example. That's it. Nothing else. This is the all the code. This is the directives. To see this much jar is required. This is the controller to handle the request to provide from the user. Okay. In the Spring MVC framework, dispatcher servlet call also front. Taking all the request is dispatcher servlet from the user. And gives to the controller all these things. I will discuss how its internal flow was there and Spring MVC internal flows. All the topics I will discuss in depth. This is that tomorrow is why, because I am winding the system in my system a little bit slow, guys. Okay, that's why. So, thank you for guys. Or please share this videos with your friends. Okay, do more support, guys. I'm preparing very good content for you guys. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for watching. Thank you for joining me.